I was at a point in my life where I wanted to find something that I could really go for, and then I found this. It's like the coolest thing I'd ever stumbled across, and I haven't looked back. I've been doing it ever since, and really enjoying it. So it's gonna be exciting to see what it turns into, but right now it's on ESPN. It's getting picked up by, you know, a huge sponsor, so it's an exciting time.
Drone Racing League on ESPN. How big has that been for the sport to have that kind of exposure?
Before drone racing was on ESPN, it was just social media, YouTube, Instagram, and whatnot. And then ESPN picked it up. It started, more eyeballs saw it, and it's just been growing, man. In 5 years, I don't even know what's gonna be of drone racing. It could be extremely massive, and it's an exciting time.
Do you consider yourself part athlete, part artist?
I think I do, because when I'm not racing drones in the DRL, I'm making videos. So I'm making videos with the racing drones to try to bring more energy to drones and drone videography. So it's a little twist on it, and that's what I'm extremely passionate about. I share all my videos on AirViews. They're a drone video website who just, they're all about promoting drones and promoting how they're good and how they can be used to capture just amazing content.
From the outside, it seems like to race drones at the level you do takes a lot of hand-eye coordination. Is that true? Because it doesn't look very easy.
No, I mean, we're flying these things at close to 100 miles per hour, weaving through courses and, you know, tight corridors. And you need that hand-eye coordination. I played a lot of sports growing up. I think that helps. I also played a lot of video games. That probably helps. So we're on these sticks, in these goggles, just locked in the zone, making maneuvers to, you know, move in and out of corridors at high speed. So you need it for sure.